Hey guys, Wells Knight here, and welcome back to another episode of Kingdoms. And we are here today in the Hall of Patrons, which has undergone a couple of changes. As you can see, we got player heads all over the place here. There's a few patrons who still have not sent me their Minecraft in-game names, so I haven't been able to get their player head. But we have a few new people to highlight. I'd say add, but they've already been in here ever since I revamped the Hall of Patrons. I just haven't actually shown it on camera. So Don Delpy, Zachary Hayes Thompson, and Matthew, I think it's Shiverdecker? Matthew! Those four individuals, thank you so much. You are now in the Hall of Patrons. And this place is looking pretty good. I am considering taking this down a level. I definitely like having just the player head without an armor stand. At least until, who knows, maybe someday I'll actually get into some technical stuff and set up like an iron farm, and then we'll have the ability to actually do armor stands with armor. But it looks a little weird having armor stands without anything on them. So I think this is the best solution for now. We may come back and revamp that again later someday, but we'll see. We'll see. Anyway, so that's the Hall of Patrons out of the way. Happy July 4th for those of you who are in the United States. I am in the United States, as many of you know, and as for my plans, I might go see some fireworks. I don't know. I need to figure out what the time is, and it all depends on how much I still need to get done and all sorts of stuff. But yeah, happy 4th of July. I hope you guys are having a good day. Probably grilling out and watching fireworks and hanging out with family and stuff like that. That's definitely the way to spend the 4th of July if you possibly can. So, for those of you who are not in the U.S., happy 4th of July, even though that's really not a significant date for you. 4th of July is is Independence Day in the U.S., so. But what I want to do in today's episode is I want to do a couple kind of odds and ends, if you will. Let's just take a little sleep here real quick. And the first thing I want to do is I want to head over to Solus. Hello, Enderman. I see you. I want to head over to Solus. And I've been looking at the wall that we built a couple episodes ago. I've been looking at it for a couple days now. Oh, that didn't... Oh, boy. Oh, that was like the worst takeoff ever. I've been looking at the wall that we built a couple episodes ago, and I have to admit, the more I look at it, the less I like it. And I'm not sure exactly what it is. I mean, I think I almost feel like it's too high, but at the same time, for a city, a big city that's well-developed and everything like that, I feel like it almost has to be this high. You can't have like a little three-block-tall wall. I don't know. The other thing that I think is kind of bothering me is this. These little kind of detail bits that we added here. And I think those are part of what's bothering me about the wall. I think they look a little bit... It looks a little bit too much like the wall is a building and not a wall. And I don't want to give that impression. I want it to very obviously be a wall. I don't want it to appear like it's a building or a structure building thing that you go inside. I'm just kind of rambling at this point. Anyway, so we could do something like that, but then that looks very boring. So what we need to do is we need to figure out a way to either revamp the wall and make it better, or I'm strongly considering just tearing it down, just tearing it down altogether and rebuilding it at a later time. Because the other thing about having this wall here is that it really kind of blocks the view from over there. And one thing is that we already kind of have this river here, which does kind of separate everything. And the big reason to put in the wall, I mean, obviously from a lore perspective, you'd want a wall for defensive reasons. but from a kind of aesthetic and building perspective, the reason to have a wall is to show separation. This is, you know, you separate where the city begins and where it ends. And that's the whole purpose of having walls around your cities and around your villages. And it also kind of gives you a boundary to work with. So you know, everything that I'm going to build has to be within this boundary, and here's where it ends. And I don't think that this wall is really doing that at the moment. Like, it's okay, but I'm just not happy with it. The more I look at it, the less I like it. So I'm kind of thinking that I'm just going to tear it down. That was a terrible ender throw. It was a terrible ender pearl throw. Let's try again. That was actually a decent throw. That kind of got me where I wanted to go. But anyway, so I think what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to tear down the wall, and we will have a wall. I don't know if I'm actually going to have it right here where we built this one previously, but we will definitely have a wall around Solus. It's just not going to be this one. We'll have to kind of go back to the drawing board, because as I said, the more I look at it, the less I like it. So yeah, that's what I'm going to work on, and I'll come back once it's all torn down. All right, guys, I am back, and the wall has been torn down, which I think is definitely a good thing. As I said, I definitely want to have a wall around Solus. I just, as much as I tried to love that design, I just couldn't. It's weird, because normally when I build something, if I don't like it at first, it grows on me over time. Well, one of two things happens. Either it grows on me over time, or I tweak it a little bit and One of three things happens. Either it grows on me over time, I tweak it until I like it, or, in this case, the third option, I kill it with fire and start over completely, which is basically what we're doing here. I like some of the concepts that we had in the wall. I like some of the general kind of basic ideas. But the wall itself just, I don't know, I tried to love it and I just couldn't do it. I think part of it was location, part of it was height, and there was some other things about it too. And I think rather than try and, tweak it and change it and make little modifications to it, I think it was easier in this case to just tear the whole thing down and start over entirely. Before I head back, let's put these materials away, and then I will meet you in Altum. All right, guys, I am back, and I wanted to check on our nether wart farm and see how this thing is doing. Looks like all the nether wart is grown, which is great. We don't have any in the chests right now, so let's see one harvest how much nether wart this will actually get us. Let's just see. We'll let that go and turn it off again. And ooh, some of the nether wart isn't ending up in the chest like it's supposed to. But it looks like a little bit over a stack there. And about a stack, two stacks of nether wart on the dot is what it looks like. Okay, so one thing I want to do today is I want to make a couple tweaks to the nether wart farm. There was some changes that you guys suggested that I think are really good ideas. So, first and foremost, I kind of forgot that soul sand is not a full block. It's slightly less than a full block. And that means that it opens up a couple of options for us. First and foremost, I need 6 more pieces of soul sand. There we go. And then I also need packed ice. What you want to bet all of my packed ice is back in Solus. All right, now that I made a trip to Solus and grabbed some packed ice, we can make a few changes to this thing. So what we're going to do is we're going to tear up all of the soul sand, and underneath the soul sand, we're going to put packed ice. And that will actually allow the nether wart to move a little bit faster. I mean, it's not really going to save us a massive amount of time because we still have to harvest and replant the whole thing manually, but it will save us a little bit, and it's not like I'm going to ever run out of packed ice in this world. I don't use it nearly enough, and we've got an entire ice plains spikes biome to ourselves. Unlike, you know, Hermitcraft, where Mumbo stole all of the packed ice for his laser going up into his base. No, I'm joking. But we'll go ahead and do something like that. Now, because these, because Soul Sand is not quite a full block, you can see it's just a hair underneath, we can actually put Soul Sand here as well. And I think, will the water still reach? It should. Now, the question is, if I take Netherwort, and we do something like this. Oh, but it won't harvest this. It won't be able to harvest that Netherwort, will it? It'll reach all the way, but it won't be able to harvest. Okay. Well, that's fine. That's perfectly fine. We can basically harvest everything else. And actually, given that we had the one that kind of ended up over here, it might be best to still do that and just not plant this netherwort right here, because it will prevent stuff from falling onto... Yeah, why don't we do that? It's going to look a little weird. Maybe we'll end up... Maybe we should use a different block. Maybe we should use, like, path blocks or something on top of the hoppers. That might be better. I don't know. Either way. Oh, hello. Instant mine. Let me go ahead and get the packed ice in over here. And there's a ghost block. Oh, hey. Okay, stop. We'll use... There we go. difficulties. Let's get this packed ice in right here. And we'll go doot 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 doot. Doot 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 doot. Okay, cool. So that's all good, and then we just need to put in our soul sand. And you move so slow in the soul sand, but that's okay. Now let's just do a little bit of a test. I can't tell if it's moving faster on the packed ice or not. It's hard to say. Let's compare the two. Alright, so we are going to run a test. On this side, there is no packed ice. On this side, there is packed ice. Let's see which goes faster. It seems like it is about the same. If anything, this side actually went faster than the other. Let's try once more. We'll do one more test. And let's see any difference. Yeah, it's either the same or faster without the packed ice. Well, that's unfortunate. Alright guys, I am back, and I'm kind of a noob. So you know how I said we had packed ice over here, or packed ice over here, and no packed ice over here? I actually did it backwards. So I think the packed ice was slightly faster, although the actual amount was pretty negligible. But either way, I think we'll go ahead and we'll leave it. Can't hurt anything. So let me just go ahead and replant the Netherwort farm, and we'll save it for another day. There we go. Wow, that one grew fast. Anyway, so let's get that going, and then we'll move on to our next little project. Alright guys, I am back, and we're here in the Nether. And I've been doing some digging. As you can see, we've kind of hollowed out areas. I've also put up I've put up some signs. There we go. So ice plane spikes going that way, and then all this stuff is down that way. Eventually, I want to do an actual tunnel design. I was originally going to base it off of this room, and then I realized that the red nether brick is actually kind of hard to get. with the speed of our netherwart farm. We could make a really gigantic netherwart farm, but I don't think we'd really have a place to put it right now that would make sense. So what I kind of want to do is come up with a little bit of a design, a little bit of a thing for the tunnel, but that's kind of a full episode project, like especially doing the tunnel. That's really kind of a full episode project. What I want to do in this episode is I just kind of want to work on this little area, just right here. This ladder goes down to the nether, so if you want to actually, like, you know, go get glowstone or quartz or any of those kind of nether materials, you can get down there like so. But I want to do something with this area, and I also want to have some storage here as well. So we're going to go ahead and hollow out an area, and let's go ahead and make it a 5-wide area. Does that seem good? Yeah, I think so. And we'll put 5, that'll be 15 chests for storage, like right here. And primarily what I'm going to put in them is just like nether wart and quartz and just stuff that I mine out as I'm working on the tunnels. I can put other building materials in there and stuff like that. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I am back. My pizza came and it was delicious and I ate it. And then we built this together. And then I realized that I forgot to hit the record button. So yeah, this is the room. It is pretty much all done, and I'm actually pretty happy with it. I think it gets the job done. We got a little bit of nether brick up here in the ceiling, which is completely black in my texture pack. Down here, we did kind of the same floor pattern that we did over here. I'm really thinking that I need to either something is not working as I thought it did with magma blocks, or I need to swap them out altogether, because it's just, like, they're really weird. These ones I already kind of did it with, but, like, you light them up, you walk away, you come back, and then they're not lit up anymore. I don't know if it's when the chunks are unloaded or what, but I may have to swap this stuff out for some other light source, like glowstone. Maybe glowstone lamps could work, or maybe even lava, although I'm really hesitant to do that with the acacia. I think lava would probably actually be a very bad idea. But we'll figure it out. We'll do something. Either way, this is our little kind of utility area as you come out of this nether hub. Basically, we just got storage for a bunch of stuff. We got our ceiling in place, we got some furnaces, and then we got a crafting table. I think technically the crafting table is a spawnable area, but I'm not super worried about it because this is the only spawnable area in this entire, like, thing. So it shouldn't really present a problem. And then going down here, we've got the end portal, the mesa, the ocean monument, and the jungle. And down this way is the ice plane spikes. So this is all sorted out and looking good. Now let's go ahead and head off to our next little mini project for this episode. All right, guys, I am back. And you can see what I mean. I came here because I realized I forgot my ender chest. It's somewhere. There it is. But you can see, this is all dark, and I just lit these up. So, I don't know what the deal is with these things. We'll have to kind of play around with it and see if this will be lit again later, or I don't know. It's kind of funky. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But anyway, for realsies this time, let's head off to our next project. Alright guys, I am back, and we are here now in Annona. And I've got a couple little things I want to do here. Nothing super complicated or anything like that, but just a couple little minor things. I'm going to need... Yeah, we're going to need to... Oh, and I left all of my spruce. Well, it doesn't necessarily have to be spruce. I just want something I can make sticks out of. There we go. Let's just make a couple of hoes. I should really make just like a diamond hoe and put mending on it. Which is almost certainly overkill, but at the same time, there's a lot of stuff that I need to do here. Like this field, I don't think I have any ender pearls on me at the moment. Let's just grab those. There we go. And let's just ender pearl up there. that was not the greatest throw in the world, but there we go. So you can see we've got kind of this farm area, and this is all kind of developing. I want to have basically this whole hill right here all be wheat. That's a lot of wheat, though. That's a massive amount of wheat. And more importantly, a massive amount of seeds. So, I'm kind of thinking that it might be very beneficial to either... there's a couple of things we could do. I mean, we could set up some sort of like a redstone thingy, but I think our best bet... Honestly, if I harvest all of this and replant it, that's probably going to be enough seeds to do the rest of the hill, I would think. I see a sheep over there who has escaped the pen. Fences are a little glitchy in 1.10 as well. They don't, like, when the chunks load and unload, sheep tend to escape from them, and it's a little... I just heard an endermite somewhere. I don't know. Either way, the other thing I need to do is I should probably shear all the sheep and get some breeding and stuff like that going, because it's been a while since I've done that, and we're going to need all the wool that we can get, because we're going to be using a lot of it in Solus, and we're going to be using a lot of it for banners and all sorts of other stuff. So let me get that done. Let me decide what I want to do with the wheat field, if I want to harvest the entire thing, or if I just want to, kind of leave it be, and we'll go from there. All right, guys, I am back, and for now, I think I'm not going to harvest this entire thing, but I do want to add a couple little things to it. So I'm thinking, like, right about here would be a good place for one, and we're going to plop down an armor stand if we can. There we go. And we'll put a pumpkin on top of it. Now, the downside to these is that... the downside to my texture pack having the pumpkin retextured so that all the sides are the same is that when you use it as a head, as like a jack-o'-lantern head, it doesn't work the way you would expect it to. You don't have a face anymore, which is kind of too bad, but that's okay. It doesn't bother me nearly as much as having faces growing on things in the wild. Let's go ahead and make some leather tunics. And if you haven't guessed already, we're making scarecrows. And I think that's something that really makes sense to have in a farm. Can I do this without... I'm trying not to break the wheat. There we go. So we'll just put a couple scarecrows kind of around here. Maybe another one right here. And we'll just kind of sneak. There we go. And... wait a minute. Leather armor, pumpkin. There we go. And then we'll put another one, I think, like right about here. And we'll do this. There we go. Oh, that was accidental. That's okay. I do actually have my hoe with me, so if I do break something accidentally, it's not the end of the world. I can just replant it. Oh, I fell. Okay, here we go. And then let's maybe put one up here somewhere, like right about here, I think. Come on. There we go. I keep grabbing my leather. There. Let's do that. And then I'm gonna put another one, I think, like right about here. That seems like a good spot. And we'll put that guy down and put a tunic on. Beautiful. Okay. Now, let's just enderpearl out of here and let's see how that looks from up there. I threw that too far. Of course I did. That's okay. From up here? We can get a decent view from up here. Not that great of a view. There we go. That's better. Yeah, that seems pretty good. We got the pumpkins. You can kind of see. Yeah, that makes sense. I think it would be better if we dyed the leather armor. just so it stuck out a little bit more. Maybe do like some red, maybe like red and blue could be really good. Let's give that a try. Let's just ender pearl down here. And let's just grab the armor. And then I'm pretty sure I've got dye over here. Let's see. It would probably be... Here we go. Let's dye that red. And put that on and see how that looks instead. That might be... This might be way better. Come on, get up there. Can I... No. There we go. Is that better? Oh yeah, definitely seems better. Let's take a little sleep and then let's take a look at it. Do-do-do-do. And... There we go. Let's get up there. Yeah, definitely sticks out more, which I think is good. I think that's good. Okay, cool. So, we've got that all taken care of. And guys, I think that is going to do it for this episode. This is probably a little bit of a shorter one, but that's okay. That's all right. We got a lot of little kind of minor things done today. I'm going to go ahead and dye the rest of these between episodes. But yeah, that is going to do it for me, guys. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it. It really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.